Pending updates to our power grid, the city will be experiencing rolling blackouts. We urge the public to remain calm during these breaks in service and to follow the guidelines on the city's website on how to plan for these temporary events. This has been a local public service announcement.
Local authorities are urging the public to conserve water and reduce the burden on the city during this water shortage. Consider installing a low-flush toilet, cut back on watering the lawn, and shower with a friend whenever possible. This has been a local public service announcement.
You're listening to Second Moon, the epitome of classical listening at home or wherever you roam.
Thank you.
Pending updates to our power grid, the city will be experiencing rolling blackouts. We urge the public to remain calm during these breaks in service and to follow the guidelines on the city's website on how to plan for these temporary events. This has been a local public service announcement.
Recent spikes in demand have led to temporary local shortages in the city's fresh water supply. The public should be aware that we are struggling to get the situation in hand. This has been a local public service announcement.
Has anyone seen my keys? My keys! What? We're on the air?
Sorry about that. It's nothing important. I just lost my keys. I'm sure they'll turn up. They're for the brown sedan parked outside the radio station. Oh, wait.
I probably shouldn't have said that. If anyone finds them, please don't
steal my car. I mean, the old hornbuckle mobile, please. Oh, good. Here they are. Well,
never mind then.
Thank you
for listening to Second Moon.
While we're not in the business of reporting rumors, there's a widespread concern over fears that an insidious underground criminal organization...
Thank you.
interrupt this program to bring you a special news bulletin. Increasing areas of forest are being engulfed by flames. The thick smoke rising from the fire makes the air dangerous to breathe. Citizens are advised to vacate any premises near the fires and remain at a safe distance until emergency services manage to get the fires under control.
You're listening to Second Moon Radio with J. Thomas Hornbuckle, and we're pervading some of the finest classical music on the air. Keep that dial right here. Thank you.
Thank you.
Recent spikes in demand have led to temporary local shortages in the city's fresh water supply. The public should be aware that we are struggling to get the situation in hand. This has been a local public service announcement. Pending updates to our power grid, the city will be experiencing rolling blackouts. We urge the public to remain calm during these breaks in service and to follow the guidelines on the city's website on how to plan for these temporary events. This has been a local public service announcement.
You're tuned in to Second Moon, the channel where the classics never grow old.
A housing shortage is driving up prices in the area.
That's right, Glenda. But apparently that's not all good news. We're joined today by an expert guest, Professor Nutbutter.
Welcome, Professor. So a housing shortage is bad for the people trying to move here, right?
Humans are programmed to desire certain representations within ideological reward structures, which are entirely apart from the actual rewards enjoyed. For example, consider capital.
One final question, Professor. Is the housing shortage going to make me richer?
By certain metrics, perhaps yes, in the short term.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction and its effect on the human
psyche. Thank you, Professor.
It is a question of priorities.
The leader of the City Services Division is with us in the studio today to talk about why they're contracting with outside agencies to provide vital services for our residents. Isn't that going to be costly, Mr. Councilman?
Well, quite frankly, yes. It is an additional expense, but the residents have come to expect a certain level of services, and we simply do not have the capacity to provide them within the city.
Sounds like we're the ones who will end up paying for it. Should we be worried?
I expect the residents would be more distressed if key services became unavailable. Their quality of life is very important to them.
But so is their money. We'll be back after this.